5 seconds to go. Start. The learned council appearing for the state submitted that the High Court has correctly relied upon the evidence of PWs 1, 2 and 25. PW 25 is an independent witness. Merely because PW 1 and PW 2 are the police officers, their evidence cannot be disbelieved. The High Court also took into consideration the documents marked on the side of the prosecution as relevant materials were indeed taken into consideration. There is no need for interference, particularly when we are dealing with a case of homicide of a police officer. Section 378 CRPC enables the state to prefer an appeal against an order of acquittal. Section 384 CRPC speaks of the powers that can be exercised by the appellate court. When the trial court renders its decision by acquitting the accused, presumption of innocence gathers strength before the appellate court. As a consequence, the onus on the prosecution becomes more burdensome as there is a double presumption of innocence. Certainly, the court of first instance has its own advantages in delivering its verdict, which is to see the witnesses in person while they depose. The appellate court is expected to involve itself in a deeper, studied scrutiny of not only the evidence before it, but is duty bound to satisfy itself whether the decision of the trial court is both possible and plausible view. When two views are possible, the one taken by the trial court in a case of acquittal is to be followed on the touchstone of liberty, along with the advantage of having seen the witnesses. Article 21 of the Constitution of India also aids the accused after acquittal in a certain way, though not absolute. Suffice it is to state that the appellate court shall remind itself of the role required to play while dealing with a case of an acquittal. Every case has its own journey towards the truth, and it is the court's role undertake. Truth has to be found on the basis of evidence available before it. There is no room for subjectivity, nor the nature of offense affects its performance. We have a hierarchy of courts in dealing with cases. An appellate court shall not expect the trial court to act in a particular way depending upon the sensitivity of the case. Rather, it should be appreciated if a trial court decides a case on its own merit despite its sensitivity. At times, courts do have their constraints. We find different decisions being made by different courts, namely trial court on the one hand and the appellate court on the other. इफ सच डिसीजंस आर मेड ड्यू टू इंस्टीट्यूशनल कंस्ट्रेंट्स दे डू नॉट ऑगर वेल स्टॉप.